Now, recently, since we have been running our online spoken English course, a lot of people have been inquiring, they've been messaging us on Instagram. Even I've received a few, you know, personal direct messages on Instagram asking that, sir, I'm able to write pretty good English. I'm able to, you know, sort of read English properly. But whenever it comes to speaking, I don't come across as somebody, you know, who has an impressive personality or who has good communication skills. Even though I'm not struggling with written English at all, but whenever it comes to speaking, that is the time that I, you know, struggle a bit. So in today's video, I will be covering a few aspects on which you can focus and improve your pronunciation. And let me tell you, pronunciation plays a big part in your communication skills. The way you pronounce words and also your voice modulation, it can have a huge impact on how impressive you come across to the other person. So even in our spoken English course, we keep telling our students that having correct grammar is not enough. You know, apart from just your grammar, you need to focus on a lot of different things, because when you're facing an interview or when you have to speak something in public, at that time, more than your grammar, the way you speak, your body language, your voice modulation, and the way you pronounce your words, those are the things that have a much bigger impact than just having correct grammar. So in today's video, I will be covering some very, very simple techniques, some very simple tips that you can easily implement in your language, and you can, you know, start seeing the difference right from day one. So make sure that you watch this video till the very end. For those of you who are new at SSB SureShot Academy, let me also tell you that apart from the SSB courses, we also run a lot of written exam courses for exams like the FCAT, CDS, NDA, INET. Apart from these, we also have subject-specific courses. For example, if you want to improve your English or maths for a particular competitive exam, we run subject-specific courses as well. Apart from these, of course, we also have the spoken English course. And let me tell you, all these courses run every single month. So if you're interested in any of these courses, or if you want to inquire more about them, then please give us a call on the number appearing on your screen. Hi everyone, welcome back to SSB SureShot Academy. My name is Romil, and in today's video, as I was mentioning earlier, I will be giving you some very, very basic tips and techniques which you can directly implement in your English, and you can start seeing results right from day one. So the theme that I want to focus on today is pronouncing the words which have an R in them. So whenever you have an R in any of the words, people, especially in India, they seem to struggle in, you know, sort of pronouncing those words correctly. For example, there are words like farm, right? So the correct pronunciation is farm, but a lot of people, you will see that they emphasize too much on that R sound, and they may say something like farm or farm. Apart from this, you can take a look at the word computer. So it ends with the word R, but a lot of people overemphasize on that R sound and they end up saying something like computer or computer, something like that. Similarly, you can take a word like the door, okay? So even in door, you are supposed to say door, but a lot of people, they overemphasize again on that R sound and they end up saying something like door, door. So since a lot of people struggle in, you know, sort of pronouncing the words correctly, I will give you three very basic rules in today's video that you can use to tackle any word which has an R in them. So whenever you see an R in any new word, you can apply one of these three rules and, you know, sort of get the correct pronunciation. Now, let me give you a disclaimer right at the beginning. Let me tell you that these rules will not, you know, apply for 100% of the cases. Yes, they will apply for a majority of the cases. I would say somewhere around 90-95% of the cases. But there are certain exceptions where these rules may not work. So without wasting any more time, let me get right into the first rule. The first rule is whenever R is followed by a consonant. I hope you know what consonants and vowels are. If R is followed by a consonant, the R will remain silent. So you will not emphasize on that R sound at all. For example, the word which I'd earlier mentioned, farm. Now R is followed by M, which is a consonant. so R will remain silent. So you're supposed to say farm instead of farm. Okay? So you can take other examples like short, S-H-O-R-T, R is followed by T, so again R is silent. You're supposed to say short, okay, not short or something like that. Another example, let's say dark, D-A-R-K. So D-A-R, R followed by K, which is a consonant, so again R remains silent. You're supposed to say dark, not dark, dark. Okay, so some more common examples I would like to cover. One is earth, right? E-A-R-T-H. A lot of people call it earth, you know, so you don't have to emphasize on that R sound at all. It's simply earth. Similarly, H-E-A-R-T, heart. A lot of people call it hurt. A lot of people also call it heart or harat. So R is not supposed to be emphasized upon in these cases. Whenever R is followed by a consonant, you're not supposed to emphasize the R sound. Alright, so that was your first rule. Now moving on to the second rule. Now your second rule says that whenever the last letter of any word is an R. Getting to the second rule simply says that whenever R is the last letter of any word, for example, the word door, which I mentioned earlier. So in door, as you can see, R is the last letter. So even in this case, R remains silent. You're not supposed to emphasize on that R sound at all. For example, take another word like poor, P-O-O-R. So R comes in the end, so you're not supposed to emphasize on that at all. So it's poor instead of poor. So another such word is computer. So since R is the last letter, you're not supposed to emphasize on that. It's simply computer instead of computer. So that was your second rule. Whenever R is the last letter of any word, it is supposed to stay silent. You're not supposed to emphasize on that. Now moving on to the third rule. Now your third rule says that whenever R is followed by a vowel, okay, A-E-I-O-U. So whenever R is followed by a vowel, you are supposed to pronounce the R sound. So this is the only case in which you're supposed to emphasize on that R sound, because if you don't do so, then the word will sound really funny. So to give you a bit more clarity about the third rule, I'll give you a few examples. For example, the word France. France is a country. So R is followed by A, which is a vowel. So in this case, you have to emphasize on that R sound. You're supposed to say France, not France, right? So if you make it silent in this case, then it will make a completely different word. Okay, so it's France. For example, brother, B-R-O-T-H-E-R. So R is followed by O. So you're supposed to say brother instead of bother. It becomes bother if you remove the R sound completely. For example, brown, brown color. So R again followed by O. So you're supposed to emphasize on that R sound, brown. You can't say bound. Okay, a couple of other examples are gravity and maybe grapes. So if you look at all these words, in all these words, R is followed by a vowel. So you're supposed to emphasize on that R sound in these cases. So let me quickly recap the three rules once again. The first rule says that whenever R is followed by a consonant, R stays silent. Second rule, whenever R is the last letter of any word, R again stays silent. Okay? So in both the first two rules, R stays silent. Now in the last rule, it says that whenever R is followed by a vowel, then R will be emphasized upon, or it will be pronounced clearly, okay? So those are your three very basic rules. It should, you know, enable you to tackle any new word with the R sound. And there are a few exceptions, as I had mentioned earlier. I'll give you one very common example. You all must have heard the word iron, I-R-O-N. A lot of people also mispronounce this word. They pronounce the R sound. They call it iron, right? But the correct pronunciation is iron. So even though in this case, R is followed by O, which is a vowel. And our third rule says that whenever R is followed by a vowel, you're supposed to emphasize on the R sound. But in this exceptional case, you are not supposed to pronounce the R sound. R is actually silent in the word iron. Okay? So there will be a few other exceptions apart from this one as well. But I believe in most of your cases, in 95% of your cases, you can just follow these three basic rules and most often, more often than not, you will get those pronunciation correctly. So in an upcoming video, I will be covering some of the most commonly mispronounced words, and especially in India. Okay, as I had covered some of the most common mistakes that people make when they talk in English. If you have missed that video, I would urge you to check it out. You can click on the I button above and you can also find the link in the description below. So I hope that you found this video helpful. Please share it with your friends who can also benefit from it. And as I had mentioned earlier, we have a lot of written exam courses. We have spoken English courses. So if you're looking for any tips or any guidance into any of these subjects, please give us a call and we will definitely help you out. Apart from this, let me also remind you that SSB Sure Shot Academy has officially launched its first SSB book. It is called A Sure Shot Guide to Crack SSB. It has been written personally by General Bhakuni along with our psychologist, Ms. Kavita Modi. So make sure it has got 5-star rating on Amazon and Flipkart. You can go there and order a copy for yourself today. And before I sign out, let me also tell you about SSB Sure Shot Plus. It is an exclusive channel. It is a new channel where we upload exclusive new videos which are not uploaded here. So make sure that you subscribe to that channel as well if you haven't done it already. And thanks a lot once again for watching this video. I will be back very soon with some more interesting tips to improve your spoken English. Until then, goodbye and take care.